Hello and welcome to another video about this Tesla model radio for the Astra Vauxhall Astra J. I got a question how this console works. This today I'm gonna give a quick review about some features, apps, speed, and everything in between. So where to begin? First question I got is how fast does it boot when you turn on the car? I have still my contact on while turned off. Put the car key in. Start the engine. And it's already there. As you can see, I have 4G reception and my Bluetooth is already connected. So how fast does it respond? It responds very fast. I use mainly two apps. My favorite app is Waze. If you don't know what Waze is a navigation app. And I prefer Waze over Google Maps because it has Spotify or Deezer integrated, you can choose, so you can immediately play music while you navigate to, let's say, Amsterdam. Let's go to the Mac. So you can see it's very fast. I'm already good to go.
Weep for yourself, my man. You'll
and you can control your music while you're navigating. Back to the home screen. In another tutorial I told you how to remove the car symbol. If you want to know how, links in the description below. Unfortunately I haven't figured out to remove this. This is a standard music app. But why would you put music on your car radio when you have internet? Like I said, I have 4G's. I bought a cheap data card, SIM card, that I put here. So I always have internet. For me, the 4G network works better than making a hotspot with your phone and connecting your car radio through Wi-Fi. You can change this button to your favorite app. So it can be Google Maps, Waze, or maybe you have another GPS app. If you want to change your car settings, like if you want to lock your doors automatically when you drive away, in the previous version there was a menu tucked some very far away in this system, but here it's just the car settings. And as you can see, there are a lot of control settings you can change. Like, for example, I don't have auto door lock when I'm driving, but if I press this button, it will lock when I drive away. So you can easily change all this. Well, like I said, Bluetooth is already connected, and if you import your contacts, you can call them. What else is there to say? Unfortunately, you can't change this to your music provider of choice. I don't really know why. The radio. It doesn't have the greatest reception, but then again, why would you put an Android system in your car when you want to listen to the radio? You can just leave the old radio in. Video. It was a video that came with the radio. I haven't figured out how to change this to YouTube, but you can always download the YouTube app here. Um, steering wheel. I don't. I have the cheap version of the Astra, so I don't have steering wheel buttons. But here you can change them if you want to. As you can see, it's very fast and responsive. Let's go in the settings again, and then in the car settings, and here you can choose your navigation apps, for instance. So I have set Waze, but if you download another app, you can do that. Here's the sleep sleep system, and that's why the console starts very fast, because you can choose from no sleep, then it will reboot every time you start the car for 2 hours, for 1 day, or for 3 days. I use my car almost every day, so I kept it on 1 day. But if you don't use it a lot, maybe you can set it to 3 days, so it will stay in a sleeping mode instead of rebooting every time you start the car. Well, how long does it take to do a full reboot? Let's see. And we're back, and already my Bluetooth is connected and my 4G is back where it should be. It opens the latest app, in this case the music app. So let's go back to navigation. Very fast, very responsive. You can also use split screen, so you can use, for example, the music app and the Waze app at the same time. I don't know why you want to use split screen. That is why I'm using Waze. Let's play some music. So if you can see how fast it loads.
Now you're not as brave as you were at the start. Rate yourself and rake yourself. Take all the courage you have left.
Oh no, copyright strike.
Wasted on fixing all the problems that you made in your own head.
If you have OnStar, you can also do some settings here. I don't have it, so I don't know. Secret menu, car settings, like I said. Here you can just read everything and look. Steering wheel, I don't have it, so. Recorder, speed settings. It is possible to get Google Assistant, but I haven't figured out how to get it working yet. If you want to go to extra settings, you have to insert the passcode, is 8888, always the same. And then you can select some other options. Here's also the option with the ruler on your rear view camera. If you want to know how to install it, you can watch my other video. But if you close this one, the double lines will go away. You can choose what apps have to be running in the background when the car goes to sleep, if the radio goes to sleep, door info. I don't have all those extra stuff. Logos, startup logo. It's always the Opel logo, but if you want to change it, you can do it. Well, don't know what else to show you other than it's very fast. So where was I navigating again? Let's go to the Mac.
It was not your fault, but mine, and it was